tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, Bill Bailey, Freddie Flintoff, Rasheen Hannity, Rob Beckett, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the word poop used to mean an abrupt sound from a wind instrument? And thinking about it, it still does. The term anti-janacular means before breakfast, and the term anti-Maureen means your mum's sister who lives in Croydon. And the L shape formed between the thumb and the forefinger is called a perlicue. And if you already knew that, you're probably a loser. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, we've got Sean Locke. I'm not saying Sean's tough to work with, but several of our producers have asked to transfer to Jeremy Clarkson's new show. And joining Sean tonight is Freddie Flintoff. Freddie's had one fight as a professional boxer, which he won. I'm not saying his opponent was a walkover, but they can't have a rematch because she's doing her GCSEs. Freddie is the face of Giacomo. You know, Giacomo, the online clothing store for men who don't care what they look like. So you sold Sean a shirt.
Yeah.
Well done.
I feel like, you know, in a film where, like, a woman gets off with a man and she's around his house, she goes, she just puts his shirt on. That's what I feel like. I feel like I'm skipping around.
Why would,
like,
that spring to mind?
He's got no trousers on underneath.
Yeah, yeah, he's got a little pair of knickers on.
I don't know what it is for you.
I'm not wearing any knickers. It is big, though, isn't it?
I think it's the lime green more than the size, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
It's like high vis.
I made a catastrophic error, but hopefully...
I like it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, nice. The final damning indictment of that show. Rasheen thinks it's all right. You two sitting next to each other. I think it's probably to do with the glasses as well. It looks like, you know, Captain America, where they give him the drugs to make him big. We took a tired old soldier that thought he was going to have to leave, and we gave him something, and look what he became.
Yeah, we're like peas in a pod, aren't we?
Yeah. Okay. Up against them this evening, it's Bill Bailey. Spoiler alert, in the new Star Wars films, Bill Bailey is what an aged Chewbacca looks like.
Shouldn't that be a shaved Chewbacca?
Yeah, shaved one, yeah, yeah.
No, Chewie's just receded from the nose out. And Bill's teammate, Rasheen Connerty. Rasheen is beautiful, intelligent and charming. Rasheen, I look at you and I think, if only I was 10 years younger and you were an 18-year-old Vietnamese boy, we could really make a go at it.
That's an insult on you.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. It's gone, this backfired. Rasheen admits she's terrible at maths and has never mastered the three fundamentals, adding and subtracting. She'll get it, give her a minute.
Aren't I the lowest scoring person on air ever?
Yes, by some margin.
Yes! That mean I'm not anymore?
No, you've been knocked off the bottom spot.
Yes! Thank
you. Sean's got rid of me. I'm all normally on Sean's team and he's obviously complained. Got me moved.
You must be really shit if he wants me.
Okay, Bill, you won the Spirit of Hammer Award.
Yeah.
Given to people that embrace a rock and roll lifestyle.
Yes.
What's the rock and roll lifestyle for you?
Well,
You see, the thing is, there's a lot of misconceptions about what rock and roll lives are. You know, it's all about people chucking TVs out windows and, you know, just trashing hotel rooms. You can do that. We've all done it, you know. But it's a bit, it becomes a bit dull after a while. And so, you know, it's more of an attitude. It's about sticking it to the man.
You can't chuck tellies out of windows now because most hotels are, like, double glazed and air conditioned.
Yeah. But you can take the plug off.
Yeah.
So they're really thin. So when they used to be heavy, it was like, now it's just like, like, you might as well drop a crisp bag out the window.
Yeah.
Just for the effort you've gone to.
Yeah, eat the crisp first, though.
Always. I'm not an animal.
Yeah. Now, Freddie, you played a bit of cricket in Australia recently. Did you pick up any Australian slang?
A few. There was the obvious ones, like third income and bonzo and all that. But then one of the lads was next to me in the dressing room and he said, I'm cracking a chubby. I said, oh, well done.
What?
Get an erection. That's what I'm cracking a chubby. Yeah.
It does sound like that. But I wouldn't be surprised. I'd go, oh. And make my exit.
But he announced that to the group. That seems like a...
Why did he have an erection in the dressing room?
Apparently, I was one of his heroes.
Sean, if you could change one rule in Countdown, what would that rule be?
Well, first, I'd like the cameramen to get a bit more involved. Come out, chip in, give us advice. Say, oi, there's another letter there you haven't used. You know, just generally get more involved in the show, because people don't realise that this is being filmed. If I could change one rule of Countdown, it would be this rule, was if you're not very good at it, you can go home. As soon as it becomes clear that you're not very good at it, you can go, can I go? And you can go.
Then I'd be on my own.
Yeah. No, you'd be at home.
Sean, have you got a mascot with you today?
Yes, I do. I've got this.
Nickets.
It's something that I have at home. I find very soothing.
What have you got?
I've got this. And it's my canalarium. I find it very soothing to look at. And as you can see, there's lots of little details in there. There's obviously a turd in there. There's a little bag of something that got chucked away in a hurry. Some dead fish, a syringe. Shopping trolley and dead rat, and my personal favourite, which is, you don't really get many of them, a canal oyster.
What is a canal oyster?
I don't ask. I find it very soothing to look at.
Yeah,
relaxing. Not just that, you'll find that very good for your bacterial transit.
Would anyone like a syringe of canal water?
Oh, there we go. Drink anything. Sorry about that.
What is it? It's canal water.
Canal water from the canal.
Looks great.
What did it taste of?
Canal. You've never tasted canal?
No.
You should try it. You need something to sully those teeth.
Freddie, have you got a mascot?
I am a bit embarrassed about it now, though, seeing as though Sean went to such effort. I've got me teddy.
What's he called?
Fred.
He's called Fred.
I've had it since I was two, Sean.
You didn't have a name for it. I can see it on your face, you went,
oh, shit.
That's the best I could come up with, Fred.
Is it Squeak?
Is it a battery?
Battery?
Yeah. She occasionally misses out important bits of grammar. But she wants to say, is there a battery inside it? She just goes, is there a battery?
It's
not battery powered, Roger.
So it's lasted that long, that noise.
It's a squeaker,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah. They're indestructible squeaks. After a nuclear bomb goes off, all there'll just be is squeaks in the world.
It's not a patch, it's just that little bit of plastic in it.
Don't pretend you know what's going on inside there.
He's explaining the technical aspect.
Just a bit of plastic, bubble plastic with a little squeeze, isn't it?
Bubble plastic
bubble
squeeze.
Bubble plastic little squeeze.
Bubble plastic squeeze, four for a pound. squeeze, four for a pound. All right, lovely ladies. OK, Bill, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I thought... this is quite interesting. Because it's a word show and everything, we're talking a bit about emojis, because they're the world's fastest-growing language. And if you don't know what emojis are, they're those little sort of emoticons on your phone. And I'll give you an example of one. This one, it's one I've made up based on the theme of the film Saw. you know that film, you know the film Saw films, where they're horrible things. You know, a bloke gets drugged and he wakes up and he's super glued to a wolf or something. And
that's a better film.
Yeah.
Saw 5.
You know what I mean? Or something like that. And there's a button he has to press that fires a gun in the wolf's head, but he can't reach it, so he's got to file all his fingers off with a baguette and glue them all together. Like a stick to... that sort of thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And this is an emoji for, you know, oh, I'm running a bit late, I'll probably see you later. And that's it there, right? So... I'm having to saw my own leg off. Right. So... what I did was, I thought I'd make up some emojis for you and Sean.
Oh, useful.
Right?
Yeah, OK.
And I've got one for you, Jimmy. Now, you're like an old-fashioned entertainer, aren't you? You know, you're dapper, you've got a good look, a very distinctive look, you're quite quizzical, and you have quite a nice face, and...
Where's this going?
You're also very successful, you know, that's the key. So what I thought I'd do, I've got an emoji for you, which is a quizzical orange with money for a face. I call it a wongarine, right? There you go, that's you. Sean, because Sean, you know, you like to do your roll-ups and he likes to drink a little bit and he likes the outdoors.
You're making him sound homeless.
No. When I say outdoor, I mean, he's an outdoorsy sort of guy. Look at him, he loves to be around trees. So what I've got... What I've got for Sean, it is Sean's nodded off in the woods and the cigarette was still burning. So, Sean's emoji is terrified villagers running from a forest fire. So that's nice, isn't it?
OK. Roisin, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I do have a mascot. I've got a pizza.
Sorry, it's your mascot?
Yeah, it's my mascot, Jimmy. Got a problem with that? Okay, I'm not lucky on this show, and I bought all my mascots in, so I've just bought in comfort food to get me through it.
What else have you brought in?
I bought in a cake. There's another part of my mascot.
Oh. Can we see how far you get through the pizza and the cake during the show?
I'll finish.
It's a bit like the flake advert, the way you eat that pizza.
Holy.
Okay. Should I put this down now?
No, eat it.
Oh.
Jimmy the feeder. here comes Jimmy the feeder.
Okay, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Rob Beckett. I'm not saying Rob has massive teeth, but rumour has it they mark a prehistoric burial ground. When Rob got married, his wife wanted to ride a horse-drawn carriage to the church, but decided against it so as not to confuse the photographer. Rob, looking at the teams, who do you think's going to win?
I can't see a high-scoring contest, if I'm honest. Because you're not great, Roche, are you?
Well, you can use those words.
And you two don't seem confident. Because I said to Freddie, you've got your glasses. He went, I need all the help I can get, but unless you were blind last time... I don't know how they're going to help. So I've reckoned to sack it off.
And with Rob, of course, Susie Dent. Susie has a weekly column in the Radio Times in which she answers readers' questions. Questions such as, can't we have a horoscope here instead? And can they replace this with a Sudoku?
Sudoku.
Oh, you got burned by Susie!
Obviously, you get recognised a lot when you're out and about.
Mm.
Is it ever weird being recognised?
It's weird when you're in labour. my midwife recognised me, and which was bad enough in that position, if you can imagine it, and then she asked lots of other midwives to come in. and I was just waiting for her to say one from the bottom, please, but she stopped.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel is absolutely irreplaceable on this show, just like Carol Vorderman was. Rachel, since being on the show, have you had any weird requests from fans?
Most of them are just, you know, can we have a photo? Can you put something on the board? Can you sign something? But I did get asked once if someone could draw me for a life drawing.
You didn't text back, though, did you?
OK, and tonight the prize the teams will be competing for are these Countdown roller skates. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. Sean and Freddie, you're to pick the letters.
You want to pick away, Fred?
Yeah. Can I get a vowel, please?
Thanks, Freddie. You.
And a consonant.
N.
I struggle with that word. I'll have another non-vowel, please.
B.
And a vowel.
O.
A non-vowel.
T.
Another one, please.
R.
A vowel.
U.
A consonant.
J. Please.
And another one.
And the last one.
Please.
S.
Well, for the first time today, the countdown clock. Roisin, how many?
Oh, terrible things happened. I've got three. I thought I had five.
Three? No, okay, three. Bill?
Six.
Six. Freddie?
Five.
Sean?
Five.
Okay, Roisin, your three-letter word.
Run.
You got run.
You shut up, Becky!
Well, I mean, runs was available, wasn't
yeah.
it?
Okay,
Freddie, what have you got?
Well, I said five, but I got confused. I got bound, but I could put an S on it for bounds.
Hold on, hold on.
Is there no D?
There's no D.
I've got a four.
Good job you bought those glasses, isn't it?
Fuck yeah.
There you go. I've got the one.
Here we go, look at that. I look like every person in Guess Who.
Sean, what did you get?
Joust.
Joust. Bill, what's your six?
Unjust.
Very good.
Very good. OK, so 6 points to Bill.
Right, up my game.
OK. Could they have done any better,
yeah,
Rob?
Yeah, they could. Give me that. I did these. Nut jobs.
Is that in the dictionary?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Outruns and burnout.
Sevens.
OK, so at the end of that, Bill and Roisin are in the lead with six. Treat yourself to a bit of cake, Roisin.
Don't you worry. This is going to change it for some check turn things around. Well, let's play countdown.
On to our first numbers round. OK, Bill and Roisin, your turn to choose the numbers.
Oh, God, the maths bit.
Yeah, because you fucking nailed the English.
You choose, Rach.
Yeah, yeah.
Just in case.
You go mad.
I'm going for one from the top. Right, the numbers are 5, 9, 6, 2, 1 and 50.
Do you know all those numbers, Roisin?
509.
OK, your time starts now. Roisin, did you get it?
Nowhere near it.
Where are you, though, Roisin? Where are you?
I'm nowhere near it, Jimmy.
What what have you got, Roisin? What number?
I'm 250.
And how did you do that?
5 times 50 is 250.
250. If you times that by 2, what is it?
Oh my God!
Can you see any other numbers up there?
I can see them. There's a 9 as well.
If you put them all together, it spells run.
This is a disaster. My mum's going to be more ashamed.
I think she'd be very proud that you got a free cake.
Okay, Bill, did you get it?
I got it.
How did you get it?
On the nail. OK, 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 times 50, 500.
Yeah.
6 plus 5 is 11, minus 2, 9. Plus all of them together, 509.
Lovely.
Perfect.
Well done, Bill.
Did you get it, Sean?
Yeah, Freddie.
Freddie, how did you get it?
I got it, like, Bill.
Oh, well, all right.
All right, by telepathy.
I still got that one.
Can we see your piece of paper?
I spelled bullshit.
Oh, yeah, no, he's got it. He's only gone and bloody done it, ladies and gentlemen. So the scores at the moment, Sean and Freddie are on 10, Bill and Roisin are on 16. And here's your teaser. The words are wet arses. The clue is can be itchy. That's wet arses can be itchy. See you after the break. Answer to the teaser. The words were wet arses. The clue was can be itchy. It was, of course, sweaters. So, Bill and Roisin are in the lead. Who knew?
Bill's winning. Bill's nailing it.
You what? Sorry, no, I was genuinely surprised.
As a team. We're doing well as a team.
I'm going to make you proud, Bill.
Thank you.
As a shit team.
Sure. Right.
OK, time to mix things up a little bit now. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Bill.
Ooh.
Bill, pick the letter.
I'm going to start with a consonant, please.
W.
Then another consonant.
S.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
N.
And another consonant.
T.
And another vowel.
O.
Another consonant.
P.
And a vowel.
E.
And your time starts now. To get back in.
How do you get more work like that?
Had an accident at work. They're about as real as my actual teeth. So. Okay, Sean, how many?
6.
Bill?
6.
What have you got?
I got points.
Okay, yeah. You got points.
I am not playing, but I did do a practice run. Penis.
I've got one, and I'm not wearing knickers.
Sean, what's your 6?
Instep.
Ooh.
Oh, that's one for you, Sue, isn't it?
Yep.
Get on it.
I'm on it.
Get your camera pen to
get on it. Of course that's a word.
Just checking it hasn't got a hyphen.
It seems like you want my penis, isn't it?
Your penis would be no good. It wouldn't be long enough.
It's
own
only five.
Is in step in
yeah,
there?
No hyphen, it's in.
6 points to both teams.
Yes.
Rob, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, I got four here, didn't I?
Yeah.
We did it together.
What'd you get?
Townies.
Oh.
Peewits. What's that one?
Poetise.
Poetise.
That's one you got.
And peonies.
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 It's great that you got them without the meaning.
Yeah, I know. I just sort of chatted them all together, hope for the best, didn't it? It's like doing a salad.
Oh. OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Freddie have 16, Bill and Roisin have 22. Now time for Freddie and Roisin to go head-to-head. Freddie, your turn to pick the numbers.
Could I have one large number, please, Rachel, and all the others small?
Okay. Thank you, Freddie. Right, they're 10, 9, 7, 3, another 3, and the big one, 75. And the target, this is really, really easy.
Oh, cheers.
OK, your time starts now.
I've got it!
Well, write it down, make sure. Check, check. No one's more surprised than me. Okay, Freddie, have you got it?
I have, yeah.
Roisin, I think you may have it.
3 plus 3 is 6.
It's 6.
Times 75.
You've only done it.
Got it!
It's a bit like clapping a bed wetter after their first dry after their first dry night. The bed wetter goes, I didn't wet the bed last night.
Freddie, did you get it?
I did, yeah, the same way.
I did. 3 plus 3 times 75.
10 points to both teams. Fine work. Rachel, are you OK? Are you worried about Roisin maybe taking your job?
I'm a fast learner, Rach.
Take her on as your protégé.
Okay.
Your greatest challenge.
So, you're fair, you've left the cake alone since you got one, right?
Yeah, no, I'll go at it now, cos I'm feeling doubt again.
Wait, is this the cake of knowledge?
You want?
I know, yes, I need it, clearly.
Choose a bit. This bit's a bit thicker. This side... this side didn't help.
This side...
This side's a smart side, I reckon.
All right, thanks very much. Yeah. I will sup. Sup from the cake of wisdom. Oh, that bit I had wasn't food. That was garnish. I think I've eaten the plastics around, but never mind.
OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Rob, what have you got for us?
Well, you know that way you say you shouldn't judge a book by its cover?
Yeah.
But I don't agree with that, because how do you know if it's good or not? You're not going to read it and then decide, are you? You've done it then.
Too late, isn't it?
Yeah, so I've got some books and I'm sort of just going to let you know what I think they're about, judging by the cover. So I've got George Orwell, 1984. I mean, I don't want to read that, like, it's just well old, isn't it? Probably leaving that one out. David Copperfield. I mean, I hate magic. I don't know about his life. John Steinbeck, The Grapes of Wrath. I think it looks good, but I can't get on board with it because of the title, because The Grapes of Wrath is what my dad calls his piles. But no matter how good it is, I can't get past that. Catch 22. I sort of want to read it and I sort of don't. this one's an absolute joke, this one, War and Peace. I mean, I don't even get me started on the cover. Have you seen the size of this? It's a piss take, isn't it? Look how small it is. It's like the last level of your optician's appointment. It's a lot of pages, isn't it?
Are you skipping to the end to see what happens?
Yeah, do you want to know?
I wonder who wins, war or peace.
Yeah. I don't get what I get. It's got like chapter 4 right at the back.
No, you're looking in the index.
Oh. And White Teeth by Zadie Smith.
be. I can't be seen reading that, can I? It's like a self-help book.
Yeah, I won't be reading those, but if I've helped a few people, don't worry about it.
Well, thank you, everyone. Rob, I've got a question for you. What was your best subject in school?
Break. Kept my morale up. But, no, not good at any of them, really. What was your best subject at school?
I was pretty good at economics and history, I'd say. Probably.
Yeah, I was good at history.
You good at history?
Mm.
Well, of course, you were there for a lot of it, weren't you? Okay. The scores at the moment, Sean and Freddie are on 26, Bill and Roisin are on 32. And here is your teaser. The words are heat nips, and the clue is give them a play. That's heat nips, give them a play. See you after the break. Welcome back. The article to the teaser, the words were heat nips, the clue was give them a play. It was, of course, thespian. Okay, before we get on with the game, Sean, I've got a question for you. Can you speak French?
Can I speak French? Yes, I can.
Could you say something in French for us?
Yes, oh, definitely, yes. I mean, I worked and lived in France for a while. I couldn't speak French immediately when I arrived. That would have been ridiculous. So I used to use the point, sniff, squeeze. You can get most of the things you want in life by pointing at them, sniffing them and squeezing them. That did me for a while, but eventually I could have full conversations in French with French people. You'd have to trust me on that.
French people who spoke fluent English.
No, I was speaking French. Like, I would have a conversation, like, someone would come up to me and say, Sean, voulez-vous un...
Hold on.
..un Mars bar? And I go, non. Je n'aime pas le Mars bar. Je préfère le Kit Kat. And then they would say, oh, quel dommage. Je n'avais pas de Kit Kat. Peut-être un topic. And I'd just go,
Okay. Bill, you've got a very distinctive style. How do you maintain your look?
Right. Well, I just don't do very much. I'm low maintenance, you know. So I
do
just
do cheeks.
I just do all I do is the cheeks. I just get one of them, you know, things that, you know, a wasp. I get a big wasp. Come in and eat all my hair off my face, and then I just grow my hair on my chin and don't cut my hair or comb it or do anything. Just lounge about.
Do you ever need a trim at the back?
Or no, just never do that.
So no. Is it peaked? Is it not getting any longer at the back? It's just peaked.
It's
that
just
length?
Peaked up there. It's gradually. It's a certain length, but it's gradually just moving that way. Eventually, it'll be halfway down my back, and then eventually it'll become a tail.
Okay, on with the game. Bill and Roisin, your turn to choose the letters.
Roisin, you want to do this?
Okay.
You're on a roll.
can I have a vowel, please, Rachel?
Bill?
A.
Any chance of cheering this up a little bit? Because picking the letters is boring.
Actually, you know, you're right, Jimmy. You know, because there are actually notes on the keyboard which correspond to the letters. So if you do the letters, I'll play along.
What, A? A is definitely one.
Right.
That's A.
A consonant.
What's X?
X is,
Another consonant, please, Rachel.
B.
Another one, please.
C.
This is working out great.
What have we got so far? Is this a tune yet?
Yeah, it's,
A murder mystery.
It is.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
E.
Brilliant.
It's building, isn't it? Yeah, I'm going to find the killer by the end.
Another vowel, please, Rachel.
I.
Give him a second.
What letter do the notes go up to?
Well, it goes A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and then it goes back to A again.
Have you thought of maybe getting a keyboard with a H on it?
It'd be brilliant.
Just do it
with
your mouth.
Game.
You can make up H, make up a note.
All right.
Sorry, the end of that.
Another consonant, please, Rachel.
L.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, D.
Brilliant. So what we've got is... Oh!
OK, your time starts now.
OK, so the target was 9 letters. How many did you get?
Why have I got to go first?
How many have you got?
3. Bad. That's the word, bad. Why is there more words there, then?
No, that's it, bad. OK, Bill, how many?
6.
OK, Sean, how many?
6.
All right.
Freddie?
5.
OK, what's your 5, Freddie?
Blade.
What's your 6, Sean?
Docile.
Bill?
Docile, yeah, docile. That's what I got.
OK, so 6 points each. Susie, Rob, could they have done any better?
Yeah, coaxed for 6 or...
Coaxed? Oh, yeah.
Cadildo.
What, sorry?
That's a B.
Oh. Ooh. Cabildo.
Cabildo. It's a Spanish town hall, not nearly as exciting.
Why would a Spanish town hall be in English?
We didn't put it in there, we're just bringing the... Is dildo in there?
Dildo is definitely in.
Oh,
the dildo's definitely in. Okay. So at the end of that, Bill and Roisin are in the lead with 38 points. On to another numbers round. Okay, Sean, Freddie, your pick of the numbers.
2 from the top, please, Rachel.
2 from the top.
And 4 from everywhere else.
Thank you, Sean. And 4, 4, 8, 3, and 1. And the big ones, 75 and 100. Ooh. And this target, 126.
Oh, I think this is Roisinable. Your time starts. Did you get it?
No.
Sean, did you get it?
Yeah.
Bill, did you get it?
Well, I got 1, 2, 4.
Roisin, did you get it?
No.
How close did you get, Roisin?
I got 100 plus 4 times 8 is 32 minus 4, 3. -3. I got 129.
Sean, how did you do it?
100, and then 75 divided by 3 plus 1.
25 oh. And 126.
Very good.
Well, 10 points to Sean's team.
Very good.
Okay, time to go once again to Dictionary Corner. What have you got for us, Rob?
Well, I like being in Dictionary Corner, but it's not my favourite corner. Okay. No offence. I'm going to talk you through some of my favourite corners. I like the corner shop.
Nice.
Handy, local, isn't it? Muller Corner. How do you do your straight in or
always
garnish?
Straight in.
Nice, Suze.
Yeah, mixed.
And a corner cover. corner on the cob. Chicken corner. And a corner, 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 corner chameleon.
Just some favourite corners.
So, the scores at the moment are Sean and Freddie have 42, Bill and Roisin have 38. Ooh. And here is your teaser. The words are porn raid. The clue is makes a wet patch. That's porn raid, makes a wet patch. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were porn raid. The clue was makes a wet patch. It was, of course, raindrop. OK, time for our final letters game. Bill and Roisin, your turn to choose.
Your turn, Bill.
OK, right then. Let's go.
I'll make noises this time.
All right. Consonant, please.
F.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
G.
Consonant.
T.
Get a vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
D.
Vowel.
A.
A consonant.
R.
What do you reckon? You choose the last one.
I reckon we go for like a U or something.
Yeah, okay. It's a U. Can we have a U, please, Rachel?
This one.
Yeah, come on in. Oh, okay.
Sorry.
Thank you
okay.
Very much.
And your time starts now. How many?
Six.
Roisin, how many?
Six.
Seriously, how many have you got?
I've got two sixes.
Bullshit. OK, Sean?
Six.
You got six. Freddie?
Five.
What's your five, Freddie?
Gated.
Gated, OK. Bill?
Grated.
Oh.
Sure enough, and Sean, you've
grated.
Got...
Grated, I got grated.
You've got grated too, OK. Roisin, you're six.
Tag?
Tagged.
Spelt wrong, have I done it wrong?
Tagged. Two G's, isn't it?
Two G's, yeah.
Not in the way Roisin spells it.
Oh. I don't know. I also had target, but that's wrong as well.
So you had two sixes, did you? I'm just reminding you of what you said a few moments ago. So you had two...
I had two sixes and gone. Gone in a heartbeat.
OK, 6 points to both teams. Susie, Rob, could they have done any better?
We had some sevens.
Grafted.
Yep.
Grifted. Frigate.
Yes.
And triaged.
Triage.
Yeah.
Triage. Oh, you got Susie to say it wrong. Whatever he's got is catching. OK, so Sean and Freddie have 48, Bill and Roisin have 44. So, crucial countdown conundrum. Freddie, how are you feeling about this? Do you think you can do it?
No. I've never got one of these, ever.
But you could do it. You could live the dream. This is where dreams come true.
You reckon on countdown?
OK, fingers on buzzers. Roisin, are you ready?
Well, you've got cake over your buzzer.
Where's my buzzer gone?
You've only got one buzzer.
Oh, right.
Oh, there. OK, well, if you...
OK, so your time starts now.
Sorry.
Sean?
No.
Nothing just...
No.
OK, let's restart the clock.
No.
Jabroust!
It is not Strabroust. OK, I mean, you've got 2 seconds to get it now. That was a weird outburst.
Outbursts!
Was it outbursts?
Yeah, I literally just said it. You'll think, oh, I've got it. Yeah, just after I said it, you got it. So the final scores are Bill and Roisin have 44, but tonight's winners, Sean and Freddie, have 48.
That's right.
Congratulations to all the proud owners of these. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night. What up, boys?
Next Friday at 8, Adam Hills with Celebs Under Pressure, a special 15 to 1 with Hugh Dennis, Alex James and Kay Burley. And Adam's back next with Josh, Alex and Mr. John Cleese for the last leg.